सह नौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। शान्तिः। ॐ आप्यायन्तु ममाङ्गानि वाक् प्राणश्चक्षुश्रोत्रमथो बलमिन्द्रियाणि च सर्वाणि सर्वं ब्रह्म उपनिषदं माहं ब्रह्म निराकुर्याम् मामा ब्रह्म निराकरोद् अनिराकरणमस्त्वनिराकरणं मे अस्तु। तदात्मने निरते यौपनिषत्सु धर्मास्ते मयि सन्तु ते मयि सन्तु। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणम् सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः। ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेदि मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐमित्येतदक्षरम् उद्गीतमुपासीत। ॐमिति ह्युद्गायते तस्योपव्याख्यानम्। न विलक्षणत्वात् अस्य तथा त्वं च शब्दात् अभिमानि व्यपदेशस्तु विशेष अनुगतिभ्यां दृश्यते तु अस्य विलक्षणत्वात्। Since Jagat is quite dissimilar in nature from Brahma, that Brahman is pure and Brahman is consciousness, Jagat is impure and Jagat is inert or insentient, because of this dissimilarities. So Virakshanatvam, dissimilarity, is presented as a hetu, as a reason why Brahma cannot be the material cause of Jagat. This is the basic Purvapaksha. Answer is given, Drushyate tu. But we do find. What do we find? Nayam Ekantah. This reason that you presented, the Hetu that you presented, that just because there is dissimilarity, therefore, two entities cannot be related as material cause and effect. Naam ekantah, that's not always applicable. It's not wholly true. Because lokehi chetanatvena prasiddhena, example is given, like from a human being who is well known as a conscious being. From him come the hair, nail, etc., which are known as insentient. Or from the cow dung that is known as insentient, it is known that scorpion and such sentient beings come out. So Purupakshi says, wait, it is from the insentient body of the human being that insentient hair and nail come out, or from insentient cow dung that insentient body of the scorpion comes out, and so there is still similarity, insentiency. So that may be so. That may be so, that there is similarity as far as insentient is concerned, but there is so much dissimilarity also. Between a human body and hair, there is a great difference. Maham Shayam Pairanamikaha Swaviparkashaha. This deviation or distance from the nature of the human being and nail or hair is very vast in terms of their appearance, in terms of their form, color, etc. So, Purushadinam, Keshanakadinam, the Swarupadi Vedat. So there may be similarity as far as insentient is concerned, let us say. But there is a lot of dissimilarity in terms of their appearance, in terms of their nature. Sa Gomayadinam, Vrishikadinam cha. And if your contention is that the material cause and effect must have sarupyam or salakshanatvam, similarity in every way, then atyanta sarupyecha prakriti vikarbhaveva praliyeta. If the cause and effect are totally same, then you cannot identify one as cause, one as effect. Therefore, cause and effect relationship itself will disappear. Atha uccheta. Suppose you say that there is this similarity, so now he wants to find similarity between the human body and the hair or the nails. This is parthivatvam, that the human body also is a product of the earth and other element, and so also parthivatvam, earthliness, is what the human body contains, and so do the nail and hair, so similarity is there. Therefore, they can be related as cause and effect. So if that much similarity is enough for you, then we say that between Brahman and Jagat also there is something common, and that is the existence is common. Existence of Brahman is inheres in Jagat also. Now Bhashyaka is asking, Virakshanatvena cha karena Brahma Prakritikatvam Jagato Dushayata. So when you find a fault in the Shruti, the teaching of the Shruti, that Brahma is Jagat Karanam, material cause of universe, when you find fault in that, exactly, so because of Virakshanatvam, because of the dissimilarity, then what kind of similarity do you expect to exist between the material cause and effect? Kim asheshasya brahma sabhavasya anuvartanam vilakshanatvena abhiprayate. Are you saying that there is total dissimilarity between Brahman and Jagat? Uta yascha kasya chit, or some dissimilarity is there. Athava chaitanyasyeti, that Brahman possesses consciousness, Jagat does not possess consciousness. Is that the particular dissimilarity which is the reason why you say that Brahman is not Jagat Karanam? Or because there is not total similarity, that's why you say it? Or because there is some dissimilarity, that's why you say it? Prasame vikalve samasta prakriti vikara uccheda prasangaha. Already pointed out that if you expect that Brahman, the material cause, totally similar to Jagat, you can't distinguish between the two. In that case, there cannot be the cause and effect relationship. You see, two things are totally similar. you cannot distinguish between this is cause and effect because they are all similar. Nahi asadhi atishaye prakriti vikara iti bhavati. If some atishaya, some distinction is not there, if the effect does not possess some distinction with reference to the cause, you cannot even call them cause and effect. Yasya kasya chit. And with some similarity is adequate, then that is already there. Dvitiyeja asiddhatvam drushyatehi satta lakshano brahma svabhava akashadishu anuvartamana iti uktam. That some similarity is there. That Brahman is existent, Jagat also is existent, therefore existence that Brahman is inheres in Jagat. So there is similarity, not there is total dissimilarity. Trutiyedu dushtanta bhavaha. To say that because Brahman is consciousness, therefore it cannot be the cause. See, you tell us. If you can prove to us that anything in Jagat is created from something that is not consciousness, the Brahmavadi, Kimhi Yat Chaitanya Ananvitam Tat Abrahma Prakritikam Drashtamiti Brahmavadi Pati Upadahriyeta. To a Brahmavadi who is a follower of the Shruti, and what does Shruti say? Samastasya Vastu Jadasya Brahma Prakritikatva Abhivagamat. According to the Upanishad, the entire universe, whatever that is, all of that is Brahman as the material cause. This is what we say. So you now tell us, if there is something which is not created from what is not consciousness, the idea is that if this cannot be proven logically, that Brahman is Jagat Karanam, nor can you disprove it logically, because do you have an example? That here is the cause, there is not consciousness from which an effect is born. Because as far as we are concerned, everything is born of consciousness. Therefore, you don't have an example. Akashadehe dushtantatvam asankyah. We say that akasha and everything is produced from pradhanam, which is unconscious. Suppose Sankhya gives an example that everything beginning from space is born of pradhanam. Pradhanam is unconscious. So that's our example. Subhashyakara says, samastasya vastu jatasya brahma prakritikatva abhivagamata. As far as we are concerned, everything is created from Brahman. That's what the Upanishad says, that's what we accept. And so for us, akasha, everything also is caused or is created from Brahman. Of course, then Ratnabara also gave the example that even avidya also cannot be said to be born of something other than Brahman. Avidya is beginningless, therefore it has no birth. And dhamsa also is something which is positive, therefore it is a product of Brahman, and not dhamsa is not abhava or non-existent. Abhavatva agrahe cha Anadi bhavatvasya upadhitvaditi. Abhavatva agrahe. If you insist that dhamsa is non-existent, then non-existent thing is not created anyway. What do you mean by creation of non-existence? So dhamsa cannot be presented. If you say, we say dhamsa is bhava rupa, because dhvamsa is always associated with some object, like ghatadvamsa, patadvamsa. Therefore, Ghata is an existing entity. Pata also is an existing entity. So, Ghatadvamsa, Patadvamsa also must be accepted as existing entity. In that case, it is a product of Brahman. If it is non-existent, then nothing is created, then it is not an example anyway. Now, continuing, Sampradi Kalpatraya Sadharanam Dosham Aha. In all these three, that there is a total similarity, some similarity or similarity of consciousness. Sadharanam Dosham, the common dosha, the defect in all the three is pointed out here. Agame, the Bhashyakara says, Agam Virodhastu Prasiddha Eva. So Agam Virodha, this view of the Sankhya, that Brahma is not Jagat Karanam, is certainly contradictory to Agama, to the Vedas. Continuing, Bhashyakara says, Chetanam Brahma Jagatah Karanam Prakrutischa Iti Agamatatparyasya Prasaditatvat. So we already saw this, that already in the Samanvaya Adhyaya, it has been already proven that Brahman is both the material efficient as well as material cause has been established in the first chapter, and therefore your contention that Brahman is not the cause of creation is opposed to Agama. Oh, then also we have seen further. Okay. Yat uktam parinishpannatvat brahmani pramanantarani sambhaveyu iti manorathamatram tadapi manorathamatram. To say that parinishpannatvat, because Brahman is an already existing entity, therefore it must necessarily be available for means of knowledge other than Shruti. Tadapi manorathamatram, that is merely a figment of a mind. Rupadi abhavadi nayamartha pratyakshasya gocharaha. Because Brahman is devoid of form or any attribute for that matter, therefore it is not available for pratyaksha or perception by sense organs, because Brahman doesn't possess sound or touch, etc. Lingadi abhavacha na anumanadina. Lingadi abhavacha, because of absence of linga or ground of inference, also Brahman is not available for any means other than even pratyaksha also. So say Ratnabhava, linga sadrusya pada pravrutti nimittanam abhava. Linga is not there because Brahman is not the cause. If cause is there, effect becomes a linga. If Brahman is effect, cause can become linga. So Brahman is not cause, effect, nothing. Therefore, there is no connection. So there is no evidence of Brahman at all. No evidence that you can perceive that Brahman is. There is no evidence of that. You can't perceive, nor can you infer. Sadrusya is not there. There is nothing similar to Brahman at all. And pada pravrutti nimittanam, nor there is any nimitta or the standard factors like jati, kriya, guna, sambandha, which are required for the use of the word. So word can only describe those things possessing one or more of these attributes. They are not in Brahman. Therefore, Brahman cannot be described in words also. Brahma lakshanaya vedeka vedyam ityarthaha. Then how do you know Brahman? Lakshanaya. By Lakshanavritti, Vedaika Vedyam. So, merely known by Veda. So, Veda is the only pramanam for Brahman, and that too, the words of the Vedas enable us to know Brahman by Lakshanavritti, not by Vachyartha. Then says, Jnayanirna, Yatha Karyatva Avisheshepi Arogyakamah Patnam Asniyad. Sarvakamo Yajeteti Atra Ekasya Manantara Yogyatvam Naitarasil Svikritam. So Karyatva Avisheshepi, even though that these are all Karya, Arogya kamaha patnam asniyat. This is a vidhanam, by enjoyment. That the arogya kamaha, the one who is desirous of good health, should eat only wholesome food. Swarya kamaha yajeta, one desirous of heaven, should perform a sudden yaga such as jyotishtoma. So both sentences are similar. Asniyat is also a vidhi, and yajeta also is vidhi. And see, yatra ekasya manantara yogyatvam arogya kamaha patnam pathyam asniyat is manantara yogyatvam, is available, even though this may be said in shastra, and still it is available for perception or other means of knowledge. So you know what pathyam is, you know what arogya is. Naitarata, but swarya kamo jyotishtomena yajeta. Jyotishtoma yaga also is not available for manantara. Swarga also is not available for manantara. So karyatya to avisheshapi, both of them are karya. In that sense, they are similarity. So just because similarity is there, what Sankhya says that whatever is a pre-existing entity, such earth and whatever, must be available for means of knowledge other than scriptures. It's not the rule. Rashniyat and Yajeta, both of these are vidhi, and still one for one you depend totally upon the Shastra. Tatha bhutatva avisheshepi prasivyadehe manantara gamyatvam. Similarly, bhutatva avisheshepi. So prasivi and other entities are pre-existing entities, therefore they are available, and they are available for perception. Brahmanastu amnaya ek gamyatvamidi. Whereas Brahman, just because they are existing entities, does not mean that the same rule should apply to all of them. So, earth is an existing entity, available perception. Brahman also is an existing entity. You cannot apply that rule. It's only available for knowledge through Brahman, through Vedas, and nothing else. So, Agama Matra, Bhashyakara says, Agama Matra Samadhigamya Evato Ayamarthaha Dharmavata. Agama Matra Samadhigamya Eva. This entity, namely Brahman, can be known only through Agama, only through Vedas. And so, like Dharma, so dharma, dharmavata, this is dharma. What is virtue? What is vice? So what is righteous? What is not righteous? For that, Vedas only are the praman. Dharma only means that the vidhi, basically. Chodana lakshano dharma. So dharma is defined as that which is enjoined by the Shastra. That's called dharma. So therefore, dharma is that which can be known only through shastra. And similarly, Brahman also is that which can be known only through shastra. Brahmanah manantar ayogyatve manamaha. That Brahman is not available for any other means of knowledge. Means of knowledge other than scripture. For that, the manam statement of scripture itself is stated by Bhashyakara. Tathacha. So Bhashyakara says, Tathacha shrutihi naisha tarkena matirapaneya proktanye naiva sujnanaya preshtha iti. Sri Ratnava, esha naisha matihi, na esha matihi, what is esha? Brahmani matihi tarkena svatantrena na apaneya na sampadaniya. This mati, this knowledge of Brahman cannot be tarkena apaneya. One cannot acquire it simply through tarka. So Shruti herself says that knowledge of Brahman cannot be attained merely through tarka or reasoning. Na apaneya, na prapani, na sampadaniya, or na prapaniya. So knowledge of Brahman cannot be attained through tarka. Or na apaneya, yadva kutarkena na badaniya nirasyana bhavati. So just as with tarka, you cannot arrive at Brahman. So just as by tarka, you cannot gain knowledge of Brahman. So also by tarka, you cannot disprove or dismiss the knowledge of Brahman. Both. Suppose there is a Brahma Jnani. No tarka can disprove that he does not know Brahman. So, no tarka can prove that I do not know Brahman. Tarka is, he can neither prove nor disprove. So that's all about Ishvara also. Ishvara cannot be proven by tarka, nor can he be disproved by tarka. So also, Brahma Jnanam cannot be attained through tarka, nor cannot be, can be dismissed through tarka. Prokta anyenaiva sujnanaya preshtha says Ratnaprabha. Anyenaiva kutarkyadat anyenaiva vedavid acharyena prokta matihi sujnanaya anubhavaya phalaya bhavati. Anye proktat anyenaiva. What anyam is other? Who is other? Kutarkyadat anyenaiva. Someone other than a kutarkika. So with empty logic, so simply empty logic, somebody applies empty logic, by that then he cannot communicate Brahman by someone other than him. Vedavid acharyana, by an acharya who is the knower of Vedas. So achinoti the shastrartham, the one who has accumulated or known the meaning of shastra. And then acharit, so sthapay, paran sthapayatyapi, one is also able to induce that acharya in others. Swayam acharate yasmat, one also puts it into practice. So vedavid acharyana, by the acharya who is a knower of Veda, by that person alone he can communicate proktamati sujnanaya anubhavaya phalaya bhavati. So when this knowledge, on the other hand, is communicated by a knower of Brahman, a knower of Veda in particular, because he knows what Brahman is, also has the skill of communicating Brahman through words also, so that person alone can communicate Brahman. He preshtha priyatamayati nachiketa samprati mrityo vachanam. This is what the Mrityu Yamaraja says to Nachiketa. calls him Preshtha, he Priyatama, oh dearest one. So that's how Nachiketa becomes Priyatama, not for any other reason, but because of what he is, that he is a mumukshu. And so he also is the one who is fit for this knowledge. That's the reason why he is dearest to. So Twadrunno Bhuyat Nachiketa Prashta. Hey Nachiketa, maybe you have a questioner like you. And so Duramete Viparite Vishuchi Avidyayacha Vidya Dignata Vidya Bhipsinam Nachiketa Sammanye. Hey Nachiketa, I consider you as one who is fit to gain this knowledge, because no amount of temptations could actually tempt you. Then further, Bhashyakara says, को अद्धा वेद कैह प्रवोचत यम विसृष्टि यत आबभूव इति च एते रुचौ सिद्धानाम अपि ईश्वराणाम दुर्बोधताम जगत्कारणस्य दर्शयतः. को अद्धा वेद कैह प्रवोचत यम विसृष्टि सेज रत्नप्रभा यम विसृष्टि विविधा सृष्टि दिस वेरीगेटेड क्रिएशन दिस क्रिएशन विच इज मल्टीफेरियस वेरीगेटेड को अद्धा वेद सो यत आबभूव This srishti, this most amazing creation, this mind-boggling creation. So looking at this universe, people's mind it is just beyond the mind really to comprehend what the universe is. Its beauty cannot be comprehended, its complexity cannot be comprehended, nothing can be comprehended. How complex things are, how most amazing and most wonderful the creation is, that take case of hand or the eye or the ears or whatever you see, most profound and also inscrutable. As Einstein said, that to us what the universe is like a clock, and what is available to us are the two hands you can see, and from that you would arrive and infer what is within the clock. Inscrutable, most amazing, most baffling, most mind-boggling, most beautiful, vastest, any number of adjectives are not adequate even to describe this Brahman, to Jagat. So the Rishi is always a wonder, looking at this Jagat, looking at this universe, what a wonderful, what a most amazing, creation it is. So Vividha Srishtihi Yatah Abhuva, from where has it come? Yatah Asamantat Bhuva. Abhuva. That it has totally come from. What is the source of this universe? Ko Adha Veda. Adha means Sakshat Veda. Who can know it directly? As to from one. Who is the one from the universe has emerged? Who can ever say that directly? Who can describe it in words? तिष्ठतु वेदनम कैह लोके तम प्रवोचत सो कैह प्रवोचत तिष्ठतु वेदनम लेट अलोन द नोइंग ऑफ दिस यूनिवर्स इन इट्स टोटालिटी इज इम्पॉसिबल कैह लोके तम प्रवोचत सो प्रावोचत हु कैन इवन टॉक अबाउट इट हु कैन इवन डिस्क्राइब दिस यूनिवर्स लेट अलोन नो इट बट हु कैन इवन टॉक अबाउट इट Meaning, so chandaso dirgalopaha pravochat, it should have been said this pravochat, यद यथावत वक्ता विनास्ति इत्यर्थ है। सो जगत एंड जगत कारणम, हु कैन से व्हाट द जगत कारणम इज, सो हु द लेट अलोन नोइंग जगत कारणम, इवन टू टॉक अबाउट जगत कारणम, दैट वक्ता आल्सो इज नॉट देयर। सो यथावत वक्ता विनास्ति, देयर इज नो वक्ता or the one who speaks about it as it is, describes jagat karanam, that also is not there. Pratikato darshitayoho mantrayoho tatparimaha. Bhashyakara did not quote the total mantra, just pratika, the first few words have been quoted. Iti ete ruchau siddhanam ishvaranam durbodhatam jagat karanascha darshayatah. These two mantras from the Vedas darshayatah clearly show durbodhatam, the difficulty or impossibility of knowing jagat karanasya durbodhatam, as to what's the jagat karanam, what's the cause of creation, is durbodham, is extremely inscrutable. To whom? Siddhana abhi ishvaranam, even siddhi perfected souls, siddhanam, ishvaranam, the lordly ones, perfected souls, possessing many powers, even for them also, it is impossible to know the jagat karanam. ब्रह्मण तर्कादि अगोचरत्वे पौराणिक सम्मतिम आह। द पुराण आल्सो से दैट सुभाष्यकर सेज स्मृतिरपि भवति अचिन्त्याः खलु ये भावाः नताम तर्केण योजयेत्। अचिंत्याः खलु ये भावाः, दिस भावा दिस एंटिटीज अचिंत्याः, दोज विच आर बियॉन्ड चिंतनम, बियॉन्ड द थॉट, न ताम स्तर्केण योजयेत, वन शुड नॉट अप्रोच देम थ्रू लॉजिक। सो भावा एंटिटीज विच आर अचिंत्याः, मीनिंग विच कैनॉट बिकम द ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ योर थॉट, विच कैनॉट बी थिंक्ड, विच आर नॉट थिंकेबल, विच आर बियॉन्ड द थिंकिंग, you should not approach them through logic for knowing them. Bhavanam achintyatvena tarka agocharatvevi. So where tarka can apply, so that which can be visualized by the mind, that which can become the object of mind, those entities can become also they can be approached through tarka or reasoning, but not otherwise. So bhavanam अचिंत्यत्वेन तर्क अगोचरत्वे भी, बिकॉज भावाद एंटिटीज आर बियॉन्ड द स्कोप ऑफ द माइंड, देयरफॉर दे आर आल्सो बियॉन्ड द स्कोप ऑफ रीजनिंग। ब्रह्मणि किमायतम, सो अचिंत्या खलु ये भावाः न ताम तर्केण योजयेत्। ऑल राइट, सो वी शुड नॉट अप्रोच थ्रू तर्क ऑफ द रीजनिंग भावाद एंटिटीज विच आर अचिंत्या, which cannot be comprehended by the mind. So, Brahmanah kim ayatam, what relevance that the statement have with reference to Brahma? So, Brahmani kim ayatam ashankya bhagavad vakyam udaharati. Bhashyakara now presents here the quotes, the bhagavad vakya from Bhagavad Gita. Avyaktoyam. Avyaktoyam achintyoyam. अविकार्योऽयमुच्यते इति च। अयम आत्मा अव्यक्तः अनमैनिफेस्ट अचिंत्यः कैनॉट बी कॉम्प्रिहेंडेड बाय माइंड, अयम अविकार्यः इज चेंजलेस उच्यते, So that is how it is. So achintya. See, achintya khalu ye bhavaha natam starkena yojayet. All right, that applies to achintya bhava. How does it apply to Brahman? Brahman is achintyam. Avyaktahayam achintyah. So Brahman also achintya means not cannot be comprehended by mind. And those which cannot be comprehended in my mind should not be approached to taraka or shushka taraka or empty reasoning. You should not approach them. Then says Anandagiri, katam avikaryoyam iti ashankya avyaktoyam achintyoyam avikaryoyam uchyate. This one is called avyakta, unmanifest. Achintya cannot be comprehended by mind. Avikaya, changeless, free from modification. So how is atma avikarya? Iti asankya janma maranayoho mana abhavat. Nobody has seen the janma of this. Nobody knows the marana of this. Therefore, the middle modifications also are not there. Your atma is avikarya, is free from modifications, free from changes, is changeless. For that, again another quotation from Bhagavad Gita. Name vidusuraganaha prabhavam namaharshayaha ahamadirhi devanam maharshinam cha sarvashah iti cha evam jatiyaka smriti name suraganaha me prabhavam na viduhu prabhavam janma na viduhu. So Lord Krishna says that they do not know my prabhava, they do not know my birth. Who suraganaha? The host of the devatas also do not know my janma, do not know my birth. The maharshayaha, even the great sages also do not know my birth. Meaning that they were not present. Not that Lord is born. The idea is that he is there before these souls are born, that's all. So, prabhavam also can mean prabhavam. But that here prabhava means birth is relevant because Lord is free from birth and death. Aham adir hi devanam maharshinam cha sarvashah. Because in every way I am the very cause of all the devatas as well as maharshis, all the gods as well as the great sages, I am the very cause of them. So says Ratnabha, prabhavam janma na viduhu mama sarvadityena janma abhavat. Mama sarvadityena, Lord Krishna says, I am the beginning of all, I am the cause of all. For somebody to cause of all should not itself be caused. For the one to be cause of everything, it should not be an effect in itself. It should not have any other cause, because that cause then is not effect of this. So for somebody or something to be cause of everything, that is possible only when it doesn't have a cause. It is itself without a cause. So mama sarvadityena janma abhavat aham adirhi devanam maharshinam cha sarvashah. In every way I am the adi, the cause of the devatas as well as maharshi. Therefore, I do not have an adi, I do not have a beginning, I do not have a birth. Therefore, I am free from all modifications. Therefore, achintya cannot be comprehended by mind. Therefore, cannot be approached through tarka. Tesham Ishvara Prabhavam Ishvara Prabhava Apramiti Kartrutve Hetuma Aham Adehi Devanam. Okay. Shruti Smriti Bhyam Brahmana Targa Abhishetva Siddhe. So, by Shruti also says, Naisha Tarkena Matirapaneya. Shruti also says, Achintya Khaluye Bhavaha Natam Starkena Yojet. Shruti Smriti Bhyam. By both Shruti and Smriti. Brahmana Tarka Avishayatve Siddhe. When it is established that Brahman is not the subject matter of Tarka, Shushka Tarka, or empty reasoning. Katham Shravana Atirikta Manana Vidhana Vidyashankam Anuvadati. But then Shruti says that Tarka or the reasoning must be applied. Atmavare Drashtavyah Shrutavyah Mantavyah Nididhyasitavyah Maitrei. He Maitri, Atma or Drashtavya, Atma must be known. How by Shravanam, Mananam, Nididhyasanam? So Mananam is of the nature of reasoning. So if reasoning has no scope with reference to Brahman, knowledge of Brahman, then how is it that Shruti enjoins Mananam, reasoning over and above Shravanam? Shravana Atirikta Manana Vidhanam. So not an alternative. Over and above Shravanam, the Shruti enjoins Mananam. Iti Ashankam Anuvadati. That Ashanka is again reiterated the other piti. Bhashyakara says, Yadapi Shravana Vyatirekena Mananam Vidhata Shabda Eva Tarkamapi Adartavyam Darshayati Iti Uktam Na Anena Mishena Shushka Tarkasya Atra Atmalabhasambhavati Shruti Anugrahita Evahi Atra Tarkaha Unubhavangatvena Ashriyate. Yadapi Shravanam Vyatirekena Mananam Vidhatat Shabdaha. The Shastra that enjoins Mananam over and above Shravanam. Shabdaheva Tarkamapi Adartavyam Darshayati. The Shabda Shruti. Shruti also shows a respect of Tarka or reasoning. So, Tarkam Adartavyam Darshayati Yuktam. Then it's okay. So says Nyayandrine, Manana Vidhana Samarthyat Tarka Matrasya Brahmani Anupravesho Vivakshita hai. Shruti Anugrahitasya Vayati Vikalpe Adyam Dushayati. So now the point is, the Tarka has a scope with reference to knowledge of Brahman. That is established. When Shruti says Mantavya hai, Atma or Brahman should be reflected upon with reasoning. Meaning that reasoning definitely has a scope with reference to knowledge of Brahman. The point is, Manana Vidhana Samarthyat. So, on the strength of Subhada Arthapatti, because Shastra has enjoined Mananam or reflection, therefore, Tarka Matrasya Brahmani Anupravesha Vakshita. So what kind of Tarka Shruti means there? Does Shruti mean that any Tarka, any discerning devoid which is totally unconnected to Shruti, any Tarka is okay? Or Shruti Anugrahita Sevayati, or Shruti Tarka which is blessed by the Shruti, which is in fact in keeping with the Shruti, vision of the Shruti, what Tarka is intended by Shastra? So when Bhudaranika Upanishad says, Atmavare Mantavya, your Atma is reflected upon, then that means there is a scope of Tarka. Is it merely independent Tarka? and related to Shastra, or the Tarka or reasoning which is based on Shastra, which is meant to explain Shastra. So Adhyam Dushayati, na anena Vashyakara said, na anena Mishena Shushka Tarkasya Atmalava Sambhavati. Just because the Shuddhi shows an adara, shows respect for Tarka, does not mean that any Tarka, whatever, Shushka Tarka, empty logic, you know, has anena Mishena. Misha means by this excuse. You cannot use that as a ground or excuse for claiming that any tarka or any reasoning has scope with reference to knowledge of Brahma. Na anena mishena shushka tarkasya ma tarkasya atra atmalabha sambhavati. Shushka tarka or mere logic, empty logic, doesn't have an application here. So Mishena, Sri Ratnava, Manana Vidhi Vyajena. So you cannot use that as the ground. You cannot use that as an excuse. You cannot use that as justification. That because Shruti has enjoined Mananam, it is not a justification of any kind of tarka. Shushka tarka means what? Shushka, Shruti anapeksha tarka. A tarka of the reasoning, that is not favorable to or not sympathetic to Shruti. A tarka of the reasoning, it must be sympathetic to Shruti or must be favorable to Shruti, must be based on Shruti. That tarka must be applied to understand what the Shruti says and not question what the Shruti says. Shrutya tatve nischite sati. So Shruti anugruhitena tarkena. So anugruhitena, so Bhashyakara explains that Shrutya tatve nischite sati anu paschat purusha doshasya asambhavanade nirasaya gruhitah Shruti anugruhitah. So Shruti anugruhitah tarka, a tarka of the reasoning, that is in keeping with the vision of the Shruti. So Shrutya tatve nischite sati, by Shravanam, when you ascertain what the nature of tatva is, like in the first chapter of Brahma Sutra, that tatparya of the Upanishads is in Brahman, and Brahman, that is one, non-dual, that means identical to Atma. Shrutya tatve nischite sati, anu paschat afterwards, purusha doshasya asambhavanadehe nirasaya. So the mind of the person, human being, human mind being what it is, will start questioning even what the Shruti says, because our experience is all in duality. So when I experience duality everywhere, how can you say that non-duality is the truth? How can it be? So purusha doshasya asambhavana dehe, asambhavana, samshaya bhavana, viparita bhavana, all these kind of questions can arise even after listening to Shruti and having understood what the Shruti says. Even then, based on our experiences and based on what we know from other sources, it is possible that we may question what the Shruti teaches. So asambhavanadehe nirasaya gruhitaha anugruhitaha. So gruhita means accepted. So tarka that follows the shravanam in order to remove the obstacles of asambhavana, samshaya bhavana, etc. So to remove those two doshas or the obstacles, mananam is recommended or enjoined. In short, by enjoining mananam, Shruti means to say that your knowledge must be free from any doubt, any vagueness, any error. It must be a crystal clear knowledge. So, whatever is required, to make the knowledge you acquire through Shravanam. So you acquire knowledge through Shravanam. So whatever is required to make that knowledge clear as a crystal, leaving no doubts, no vagueness at all, then for that what is important, required is reasoning. Because it is through some kind of reasoning that our mind says this cannot be true. Even though Upanishad says that Sneha Nana Asti Kinchana, in Brahman there is no Nana, there is no duality, whatever. So it says. But my mind says, where is non-duality? I do not see non-duality anywhere. Whatever I see is just duality, division, mutual exclusion. That's what I see everywhere. So mind itself will question the conclusion or the teaching of the Shruti. And like that, you know. Also, as Vashyakara discussed in great detail, Kshetrajnyam Chapimam Viddhi Sarvakshetreshu Bharata. He Bharata, in all the Kshetra, in all the personalities, I am the person. Oh, Narayana is the Atma. Does it mean Narayana is a samsari or what? Because Atma appears to be samsari. Or Narayana cannot be samsari, then Atma also cannot be samsari, but I experience samsara. So what the Upanishad says appears to contradict the conclusions we arrived at from our experience. Understand that it is not the experience that is a problem, it is a conclusion derived from experience. So whatever I experience, from that I arrived at the conclusion that I am a limited entity. Now that's a conclusion, not an experience. So what is happening is limitation of the body mind are automatically, habitually superimposed upon Brahman. I lump them together and I declare that Atma or Brahman is limited. In short, what the Upanishad teaches seems to contradict my present experience and my present conclusions. Therefore, there has to be an alignment in my understanding, and my Shruti's understanding should become my understanding, when all doubts and all vagueness is removed. And for that, mananam is required. So Shruti Anugruhita Eva Atyatya Tarka Anubhavangatvena Ashriyate. So Shruti also resorts to Tarka or reasoning. But Shruti Anugruhita, meaning that which is in keeping with the vision of the Shruti. Tarka or the reasoning which is applied to understand what the Shruti says rather than question what the Shruti says. Atra anubhavangatvena, as anga for anubhava or direct realization, tarka has a role there. Anugruhitastu niralambanatvat natra upayujyate. So what is not in keeping with Shruti is not useful here. Tathacha tarkamatrasya atra apraveshat tarka visheshasya cha Shruti dvara anupravesh avirodhat tarka agocharatvam manavidhanam cha ityartha. On one hand, naisha tarkena Mati Rapanaya, Mati is beyond Tarka. The same time, Mantavya, Shastra says that Atma must be thought about, reflected, how do you reconcile between two apparently contradictory statements? Tathacha tarka matrasyatra praveshat naishat tarkena mitirapanaya, means just any tarka, with that you cannot in fact attain this knowledge. Visheshachya shruti dvara anupravesh avirodhat, but vishesh tarka, shruti anugruhita tarka, tarka which has the blessing of the shruti, tarka which is meant to explain what the shruti says. So pravesh avirodhat, that tarka has an entry here. Therefore tarka agocharatvam man vidhanam cha, tarka gocharatvam, not gochara, not approachable to any tarka, but certainly is available, you know, certainly the favorable tarka is definitely useful in the direct knowledge. Shruti akankshitam tarkameva mana vidhi vishayam udaharati. So Bhashyakara is very kind, gives us what kind of tarka has a scope here. Shruti akankshitam tarkam, what kind of akanksha, what kind of expectancy the shruti has with reference to tarka, which is enjoined in mananam. So mana vidhi vishayam, the tarka which is the subject matter of manana, vidhi or enjoyment of mananam, which the shruti accepts, what is the nature of that tarka? So udaha bhashyakara gives example of that tarka. Swapnandri bhashyakara says, swapnanta buddhanta yoho uvayoho itare taravya vicharat आत्मनः अनन्वागतत्वं संप्रसादे च प्रपञ्चपरित्यागेन सदात्मना संपत्तेः निष्प्रपञ्चसदात्मत्वं प्रपञ्चस्य ब्रह्मप्रभवत्वात् कार्य कारण अनन्यत्व न्यायेन ब्रह्म व्यतिरेकः इति एवं जातीयकः. सो तर्क हैज सी रत्न प्रभा, व्हाट इज द शुद्धि अनुग्रह तर्क, जीवस्य अवस्थावतः देहादि प्रपंचयुक्तस्य निष्प्रपंच ब्रह्मैक्यम असंभवे. असंभावना, हाउ कैन जीवा बी ब्रह्म? जीवस्य अवस्थावतः, आई गो थ्रू दिस स्टेट्स कॉल्ड वेकिंग, ड्रीम, डीप स्लीप. देहादि प्रपंचयुक्तस्य, आई पजेस बॉडी, सेंस ऑर्गन्स, mind, intellect, that's the jiva that I am. Nishprapancha brahmaikyam asambhavi, therefore impossible that I could be Brahman. Nishprapancham, that's beyond the prapancha, beyond the samsara, and also not undergoing any states, etc. So Brahman is transcending everything. How can I, a samsari, be Brahman? So asambhavi, this asambhavana arises. Then dvaita grahi pramana virodat brahmanascha advitiyatvam ayuktam. They say that Brahman is non-dual. Brahman is the jagat karanam, the adhisthanam, the substratum of the entire universe. The basis of the entire universe is in non-duality. Whereas what I experience is duality and division everywhere, mutual exclusion everywhere, and they say that here is the reality that does not exclude anything. How can it be? Idevam shrautartha asambhavanayam. So shravanam you have done, shrautartha. So you understood what the Shruti says through shravanam asambhavanayam, but my mind raises these questions and thinks that what the Shruti says is not possible. Or I am alpagnya, alpashaktiman, how can I be Brahman, etc., etc. So, thus the asambhavana arises after we listen to Shruti. Tan nirasaya, for removing that tarka, removing that asambhavana rather, sarvasu avasthasu atmanah anugatasya vivicharani bhi avasthabhi anandvagatattvam asamspruṣṭatvam. Says no, atma is not avasthavatah. Sarvasu avasthasu atmanah anugatasya. Atma is anugatam, is present in all the avastha, in all the three states, waking, dream and deep sleep. Vivicharanabhi avasthabhi anandvagatattvam asangoyam purushah. So ten anandvagatah ten asangoyam purushah. Upanishad said that how atma simply at will moves from one state to the other, like a big, very powerful shark goes from one bank to the other. So atma goes from waking to sleep and back, and they were unconnected to them. Therefore, atma is not avasthavatah. Atma does not possess this waking, dream and deep sleep. They are the states of mind, not of atma. So, vivicharanabhi, avasthabhi, anandvagatattvam, meaning asamspruṣṭatvam. These avasthas are vivicharani, mutual exclusive. Where the waking is, dream is not, and dream is, waking is not, etc. So, these avasthas, the states, exclude each other. But they do not exclude atma. Atma passes through all the three avasthas and still untouched by them. Avasthanam. Also, avasthanam svabhavikatve. Suppose you insist that no, atma is a waker, atma is a dreamer, atma is a sleeper. So waking, dream, deep sleep, these avastha, the states, are the nature of atma. Suppose somebody says, then vrni aushnavat atma vichara ayogat. If waking was the nature of atma, you would always be awake. If dreaming was the nature of atma, you would always be dreaming. Vrni aushnavat, like aushnam or heat is the nature of fire. The fire is never devoid of heat. Similarly, if these avasthas were the nature of atma, atma cannot be devoid of the avasthas. So, Vashyakara said, Svapnanta buddhantayoho ubhayoho itaretara vyavicharat. Svapna, the sleep. Buddha means the awake. So, sleeping and wakefulness. Ubhayoho itaretara vyavicharat. When sleep is there, wakefulness is not there. When wakefulness is there, sleep is not there. Itaretara vyavicharat. They exclude each other. Atmanah anandvagatattvam, which means that atma at will passes through the states. That means that atma is not identified with either of them. Svabhavikatve, as Ratnava said, if avasthas were the nature of atma, atma could never be devoid of the avasthas, but atma is, that means avastha is not the nature of atma. देन संप्रसादे च प्रपंच परित्यागेन सदात्मना संपत्ते निष्प्रपंच सदात्मत्वम्. ओके, विल कंटिन्यू दैट टुमारो नेक्स्ट क्लास. ओम पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते. ओम शांति शांति शांतिः. शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्य कृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः. ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेदि मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः. ॐ शांति शांति शांति. हरि ओम. श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः.